After 20 long years in Afghanistan, the U.S. is on the verge of withdrawing all of its forces from the country, bringing an end to this nation's longest war. For weeks, the brave men and women of the U.S. military have been heroically evacuating their fellow Americans and Afghan allies by the tens of thousands. There were so many hopes that our troops would make it home without any more casualties. And then Thursday happened. In an act of pure cowardice and evil, the terrorist group ISIS-K set off an explosion that killed 13 U.S. service members and as many as 170 Afghans. The terrorists exploited what was an obvious soft target outside of the airport in Kabul. U.S. Marines, who are courageously providing security for what has been an overwhelming evacuation process. As military commanders explained, the Marines were clearly vulnerable as they were placing their hands upon the evacuees one by one.
This is close-up work. The breath of the person you are searching is upon you. While we have Overwatch in place, we still have to touch the clothes of the person that's coming in. I think you all can appreciate the courage and the dedication that is necessary to do this job and to do it time after time. Please remember that we have screened over 104,000 people.
Just for a moment, imagine the courage it takes to do that job. It is impossible to describe the pain and suffering unleashed by these terrorists, both at the scene of the attack and inside the homes of the families of the fallen. So many lives will never be the same. It is often said that war is hell, but Thursday felt like one of the darkest corners of that hell. These fallen U.S. service members gave their lives evacuating women and children. They were on a mission to end America's engagement in Afghanistan with some measure of compassion and dignity. They represented the best of this country. If there were ever a moment for some sense of national unity, this was it. And yet, in the hours that followed, the divisions in this country were all too apparent. Appearing on Fox, former President Donald Trump immediately pounced on the attack in Kabul, boasting his administration killed bigger terrorists than Osama bin Laden, the al-Qaeda leader behind 9/11.
If you look at al-Baghdadi, he was the founder of ISIS. We took him out. Nobody could find him for 15 years. Far bigger than Osama bin Laden, far bigger. Osama bin Laden bad, and he hit, you know, the World Trade Center, and it was a horrible thing. But al-Baghdadi was the founder of ISIS.
Trump, who once bragged he had eliminated ISIS, at times referred to ISIS-K, the group the U.S. believes is likely behind the Kabul attacks, as ISIS-X.
There's great danger right now. They have unbelievable weapons. They have people, as I said, that broke away because they weren't, because the Taliban wasn't mean enough and vicious enough. And that's the new ISIS-X, where they broke away, or ISIS-K. They'll have an ISIS-X pretty soon.
Trump's son, Don Jr., tweeted a photo of President Biden hanging his head during his remarks Thursday and accused the president of weakness. Other Republican leaders went further, insisting Biden should resign or be removed from office using the 25th Amendment. Tennessee Senator Marsha Blackburn tweeted that Biden and other top administration officials should step down. It should be noted, back in 2019, she said the American people were ready to end the war.
The American people are war weary. They want this settled.
Missouri Senator Josh Hawley also called on Biden to resign. Last April, he tweeted that the president should pull troops out of Afghanistan by May 1st of this year, as if it would have been less chaotic back in May. Now, President Biden should expect some of this criticism. That is politics. But it's the knee-jerk immediacy of these political attacks that stands out. This wasn't Monday morning quarterbacking. That would have meant waiting until the next morning. No, this is Monday morning exploitation, and it's shameful. Much has been written about President Biden's handling of the U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan and whether there was adequate planning for this exit from America's longest war, or whether it was a good idea to work with the Taliban, or whether it was smart to go through with a peace deal brokered by the Trump administration. All important questions. As Biden said, the buck stops with him. He's the president. But there used to be a time and place for politics after so much bloodshed. So many times we hear politicians simply offer thoughts and prayers. Well, if there ever was a moment for just thoughts and prayers, this was it. The tweets, the statements this time should have been about putting the troops first with thoughts and prayers. Thoughts and prayers for the Marines and our other service members who died Thursday. Thoughts and prayers for their families. Thoughts and prayers for the troops leaving Afghanistan as we speak. Thoughts and prayers for the Afghan people and for this country. Just imagine, just this once, if we simply offered our thoughts and prayers. Give it some thought. Pray on it.